I'm Jonnay, and it's time for onesies. No, not like that. In the old days of analog recording, you'd have these massive mixing consoles. You know, like that, but bigger. Way more knobs. Now, in the really big fancy kind, like the Fairchild Delight Nev whatever mixing desks, each channel on your mixer was encapsulated in this thing called a channel strip. And on it, you'd have, say, a preamp, probably some sort of EQ, maybe a couple of effects if you were lucky or rich. Nowadays, at least in Ableton Live, each channel strip has got a volume, a pan, and then like a zillion different DAW features. But there's something to be said about having a standard set of effects per channel. Enter the channel onesie. I have this thing set up as the default effects for every audio and MIDI track in Ableton. And this is a standard suite of tools that I use mostly in the mixing section of my workflow. So it's a rack of racks, cause yo dog, and each rack is suited to a particular task. And the most common controls for each of those tasks are situated in the rack of racks. Cause yo dog. Enough talking though, let's take a peek. In its default state, everything is in pass-through mode. None of the effects are on until you start twiddling knobs. There's a preamp knob, which aside from boosting and cutting, is really good for any kind of volume automation. There's stereo width, which should be mostly self-evident. Low cut and high cut EQs for that sexy EQ bracketing. There's a compressor, which is kind of the weakest link in the chain. I haven't found the perfect set of settings for it, but currently it's got attack, release, and ratio. The threshold is locked at negative 12 dB, but with a ratio of 1:1, you won't even notice. And finally, there's a single knob saturator. Like I said, each section here is in a rack with its own controls. Inside of the preamp section here, there's a bass monoizer because it's important to have your bass mono for the most part. And the compressor and the saturator expose way more controls. What I really love about this thing is that it really embodies my workflow. Like it functions as a checklist of sorts. Is this track gain staged? Check. What is the stereo image doing? Is it good? Check. Do I need EQ? Check. Compression? Check. Saturation? The first question is always, do you need it? Sometimes the answer is no. Sometimes in the middle of a mix, I'll actually end up inserting other effects in line, and that's fine. This is meant to be expandable. It's the first word, not the last. But ultimately, this gives me a good starting point without even having to think about it. It's just right there and I can start using it, and it's nice and comfortable. You know, like a good pink bunny onesie.
There is no good pink bunny onesie.
So this rack uses nothing but standard Ableton effects. I've put it up on Audio Bombs, so if you want to go download it, be my guest. I encourage you to take it and break it and make it your own. Make it work with your own mixing workflow. Maybe give it a less cute name, or cuter, or cutest, or cuterest. And until next time, onesies are fun!